A man sits down at his table with his wife and two sons and explains to his sons that there are basically three types of people in this world. There's the wolves, there's the sheep, and the sheepdogs. Well, the wolf is a predator who attacks the weak, preys on the weak. The sheep are the ones who are usually the weak, or the people who stand by and let the wolf attack. And then there's the sheepdog. The sheepdog is the protector. Well, one of those boys actually grew up to become one of the most lethal U.S. snipers in American history. I'm Reginald, and this is my review of Clint Eastwood's American Sniper. Hey guys, welcome back. American Sniper actually turned out to be a much better movie than I anticipated. When I first heard about this movie, I thought it was going to be essentially like that movie they showed in the third act of Inglourious Basterds, where the sniper is shooting an impossible amount of people and it's just pure propaganda. You may still consider this film to be propaganda, but I will say this. Clint Eastwood is a very capable director, as you know, and he does an excellent job of showing how troubled this guy was and how the war affected him. This young man, Chris Klein, grew up. He had a younger brother who also went into the military, but Chris Klein at age 30 actually decided to enter the U.S. military. He actually became a U.S. SEAL, U.S. Navy SEAL, which was pretty impressive, especially at his age, actually getting started with that. So we follow his many tours, his four tours in Iraq, and he turns out to be an incredible sniper. He's actually able to protect a lot of soldiers, and the movie sort of focuses on what he's able to do as far as stopping threats. There's scenes where there's a woman trying to blow up an envoy of American soldiers, and he has to decide in that split second to take the shot or not. Of course, if he's wrong, he can end up in prison, but if he's right, you know, he can save lives. He can save American lives. And you can see, it's even though he feels obligation to join his comrades, join his soldiers. I can't believe I used the word comrades. But anyway, join the soldiers in war. You also see it wear on him. You see how it affects him and his relationship with his wife. You see that it affects his relationship with his children. Although I wish I saw a little bit more of that. But Clint Eastwood did a great job with 2 hours and 14 minutes. He did a great job of showing what this man accomplished and the toll of war. And the action scenes are absolutely incredible. You don't get confused for a second. You know exactly what's going on. There's overviews that really help you understand where the buildings are in relation to one another, which really helps out. So American Sniper, a very effective drama, great actioner, great action movie. And I'm sure you guys know the rest of the story. I'm not gonna spoil anything else. I recommend it. I definitely give that an 8.5 out of 10. 8.5 out of 10. I definitely strongly recommend this movie. Next, Kingsman. Kingsman, the Secret Service. Okay, this movie, I didn't know what to expect. From the advertisement, I mostly saw that henchwoman, the henchman or the henchwoman who was working for the villain. The villain is actually played by Samuel Jackson, and this character has a slur. Now, I'm not going to say too much about his ultimate plot, but he has a really big idea, and it actually involves free cell phone SIM chips. But I'm not going to spoil it too much. The story really begins 17 years ago when Hartie, a veteran agent, was working with a number of other agents, including a new agent. And this new agent actually saves his life by jumping on a grenade. And Hartie goes to the man's child and his wife and tells him, hey, I'm going to give you this medallion or something. I want you to know that if you ever get into trouble, you ever need me for anything, let me know. I'll do whatever I have to do to help you out. Well, eventually this kid grows up. He's raised by a single mom. She ends up dating this bully, this abusive asshole. And this kid gets into a lot of trouble. He's young. He was in the military, but he dropped out. He's very smart, but he's not really utilizing his talent. Well, his name is Eggie. What type of name is that, Eggie? But anyway, Eggie isn't using his talent. He gets into trouble with a bunch of goons, and he ends up in jail. He uses a coin or whatever, and Hartie comes to the rescue, and Hartie decides to recruit him as a possible Kingsman, an agent for this secret organization. So secretive that nobody really knows anything about it whatsoever, and they sort of work completely out of the limelight. You never see anything they do in the newspapers or anything like that. So it's sort of a cool British organization. So eventually Eggie joins the recruiting process. He goes into training. And a lot of that sort of reminds me of that movie, Divergent. They say that only one person will make it. Only one person will get this job, this position. And so immediately they go through all this training. I'm thinking of Divergent. I'm thinking of Hunger Games and all this other stuff. But I'm not going to go too much into it. Eventually, he's sort of forced to get into the game. And he has to face off with Samuel L. Jackson, who is one of the lamest, one of the softest villains ever. The guy really doesn't want to get his hands wet, and he has this slur in his speech, which is kind of annoying. I mean, really annoying throughout the movie. But it's used for comedy pretty effectively. Although I wish they used it a little bit more, because if we're gonna have to listen to that, they should have used that a little bit more. But anyway, interesting enough, this movie is very, very violent, very violent. You see a lot of body parts getting cut off and all this other craziness, right? But you don't see a lot of sex, although you do see some sex towards the end, which is kind of interesting. Sort of reminds you, oh yeah, yeah, this is an R-rated movie. There are some scenes that are definitely controversial, to say the least. So strap in, and when you see this movie, be prepared to be entertained. It did an excellent job of entertaining me. I would definitely give this movie a solid 8 out of 10. Definitely recommend it. And understand, you're going to see this movie to be entertained. You're not going to see. It's very different from American Sniper. It's an effective comedy. It's an effective comedy action. Recommend both of these films. If you guys have any questions, see me in the comment section. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for today. Why didn't I see 50 Shades of Grey? Because I read about half the book and I couldn't get through the rest. It was just, it's one of the worst books ever. It's such lowbrow trash. It's, you know, I can really get into the exotic thriller thing, but it's just, okay, this rich girl, no, this average girl goes to see this rich guy and she's there to interview him, and oh, he seduces her. He's only able to do all this because he has money. She only allows him to do all this crap because he has money. And this is supposed to be the big Valentine's Day movie. I mean,